fell heavy into your arms. These days of darkness, which we've known, will blow away with this new sun. But I'll kneel down, wait for now. And I'll kneel down, know my ground. And I will wait for you. And I will for you. So break my step and relent. Will you forgive and I won't forget. Know what we've seen. Now in some way shake the excess. As well as strong, and use my head alongside my heart.
Here we are, day four. Bright, mild day here. We switched up here, yes, and we went to the mouthway from where we've been. Yeah, we've gone across a couple meadows here. Hopefully, something jumps out at us today.
So we came up here to this lookout, or a good vantage point, and we spotted this bear, and he must be at least a mile, definitely a little further than a mile away. Basically the last hillside that we can see, that's meadow, that's the bear, beautiful chocolate color. There's a perspective for you of how far away he is, and here's Shane. He's getting all of his stuff on, and he's gonna go for him from here. I'll try to lead him in. We've got cell service, so hopefully I'll be able to call him and let him know what's happening, and hopefully we can get a bear down.
Taking your GPS.
There goes Shane. Wild Blue Yonder. Again, hopefully he'll hit that ridge. Finds his way through that first ravine. Walk across that meadow. Finds his way through that second ravine. Hit to that bump. There's a third ravine. Who knows how deep that guy is. Down here to where the bear was. Just walked through there. There he is. And unfortunately, I just saw the bear go under the trees. I whistled for him. I called him. No answer. So I watched the bear. I saw her where she went in the trees, and I saw a couple more glimpses of her through the light areas of the forest. And maybe she comes back out by the time he gets there. Hope so. Good luck, Shane.
Well, it's the last night of our trip, and saw two shooters on the ridge behind us this morning, and put them to bed, and hoping to get lucky and find one of them come out tonight. We glassed it from across the canyon for about 2 hours, nothing came out, so we have about an hour and a half daylight left, and hoping to get lucky, otherwise we're headed home empty-handed. See how things turn out.
Four nights, 5 days is pretty hard work.